Hi students, coming to the next topic in the data communications, that was the protocols and the standards. So in the previous video I explained about the what is the data communication and what are the components that are present in the data communication. Now let's see what do you call protocol and what are the standards. So I said the protocol is nothing but it consists of set of rules that govern data communication. Okay, first let me explain what is a protocol and what is a standard. Okay, protocol, it consists of set of rules that govern data communication. So this was the definition of the protocol. A protocol is nothing but it consists of set of rules that govern data communication. So what exactly this protocol determines? It determines what is communicated. So I am saying it is a set of rules. What is that rules? What are those rules that it has to follow, the sender and the receiver? So the rules are nothing but what is communicated, what is going to be communicated, how it is communicated, and when it is communicated. So these are nothing but the set of rules, set of protocols that the device has to follow. What, how, and when. Okay. Now let's see what are the key elements that are present in the protocols. So this is the definition of protocol, and the protocol determines what is, how is, and when it is communicated. And what are the key elements of protocol? Let me explain the key elements of protocols. Key elements of protocols. The different key elements of protocols are, one is syntax, next semantics, and next timing. So these are the main three elements that are involved in the protocol. If you are discussing anything about the information, if you are following some set of protocols, a protocol consisting of these three main key types: syntax, semantics, and timing. So what is syntax? Here syntax is nothing but the structure or format of a data. What type of structure or format of data you are sending, that represents the syntax, format of data. And it indicates how to read the bits also. The syntax is useful to helpful in how to read the bits. That about the syntax. And what about the semantics? Semantics is nothing but it is going to interpret the meaning of the bit. So here we are indicating how to read the bits, and the semantics is useful to helpful in interprets the meaning of the bits. Interprets the meaning of the bits. And it also knows which field defines what action. The semantics is explaining which field defines what action. Knows which fields define what action. Now let's see what is the timing. What do you indicate by timing? What are the what is this key element of protocol timing does? So the timing is nothing but here when data should be sent and what data we have to be sent. When data should be sent and what data we have to be sent. And it also sees the speed at which data should be sent or speed at which it is being received. It also concentration on the speed. A speed at which data should be sent or a speed at which it is being received. So this is a timing. So here I explain what is a protocol, okay, and what it exactly the protocol determines. And what are the main key elements of the protocols? Syntax, semantics, and the timing. Now let's see what is the standards. So what is the difference between this protocol and the standards? I said protocol is a consisting of set of rules which governs the data communication. And what about the standard? A standards provides guidelines to manufacturers or vendors. It's just providing a guidelines. Okay, let me write the definition. Standard provides guidelines to manufacturers. Means while they are developing something, the vendors or the manufacturers, they have to follow some guidelines, that you call it as a standards. Means this organization is following some standards, another organization is following some standards, like that. It provides the guidelines to manufacturers, vendors or the government agencies. Government agencies and other service providers. And other service providers to ensure the kind of interconnectivity necessary in today's marketplace, in today's market place and even in international communication, and in international communication. So who are the providers, service providers or the government agencies or even the vendors and the manufacturers, everyone is following some set of kind of interconnectivities to ensure the kind of interconnectivity necessary in today's marketplace. Even the international communication also, every person is following some set of guidelines. Okay, so that guidelines, if they are following some set of guidelines to develop any product, so that you call it as a standard. So standard is nothing but agreed upon rules. We call it as standards is nothing but agreed upon rules. A set of protocols are there, rules. So this standards is nothing but they are agreeing on those rules. If they are agreeing on those rules, then it becomes that organization is becoming following some exact standards. A standards is nothing but agreed upon rules. A different categories of standards are there. Let me show you. Categories of standards. So what are the categories of standards? One is de facto and another is de jure. What is de facto and de jure? The de facto is nothing but by convention or by fact. We call it as by convention or by fact. And de jure is by law or by government. By law or by government. So these are the two categories of the standards, de facto and de jure. So standard is nothing but, it is nothing but agreed upon rules. So I'll just give a brief idea what are the standard organizations for data communications. So if you take some of the standards for data organization, standards organizations for data communications. So the different standard organizations for data communications are nothing but ISO is nothing but International Standard Organization. So this International Standard Organization having International Telecommunication Union, ITU, and it is having some following some IEEE standards. It's nothing but Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, and it is ISO standard is also having some ANSI organized standard organization, that is the American National Standard Institution. Okay, And this ANSI is having EIA standards as well as TIA standards. EIA is nothing but Electronics Industry Association. TIA is Telecommunication Industry Association. So these are nothing but the standard organizations that are used for data communication. ISO, this is a main international standard organization. So this international standard organization is divided their work and allotted some different standards for different purpose of data communication. Okay, so this is about the standards and the protocols. Thank you.